you have cough or fever, either low grade or high grade, with breathing discomfort or any other symptoms, then the only way to find out whether you have COVID-19 or not is to get tested. Now the question arises, which test to get it done? Listen to this video till the end to find out about the different kind of test available, which diagnostic test is best, and how each kind of diagnostic plays a role in fight against COVID-19. Welcome to Intellect Medicos, where learning is made easy, by Dr. Shruti and Dr. Chirag Madan. Information provided by Intellect Medicos is not meant to substitute for medical advice by any physician or experienced healthcare professional. Always seek advice from your physician about the clinical condition and usage of particular treatment or therapy. So now let's start. In response to growing COVID-19 pandemic, multiple diagnostic test manufacturers have developed and begun selling rapid and easy to use devices. However, before these tests can be recommended, they must be validated in the appropriate populations and settings. Inadequate tests may miss patients with active infection or falsely categorize patients as having the disease when they do not have, further hampering disease control efforts. Before diving into the topic, let me explain you two terms which are very commonly used when we talk about diagnostic tests. These two terms are sensitivity and specificity. Sensitivity is also called as true positive rate. It measures the proportion of actual positives that are correctly identified as such. For example, the percentage of sick people who are correctly identified as having the condition. Second, specificity, also called as true negative rate. It measures the proportion of actual negatives that are correctly identified as such. For example, the percentage of healthy people who are correctly identified as not having the condition. Let's talk about these tests one by one and which one of these tests is gold standard. First, rapid diagnostic test based on antigen detection. This test detects the presence of viral proteins, that is antigens expressed by the COVID-19 virus in a sample from respiratory tract of a person. If the target antigen is present in sufficient concentration in the sample, it will bind to specific antibodies and generate a visually detectable signal, typically within 30 minutes. The antigens detected are expressed only when the virus is actively replicating. Therefore, such tests are best used to identify acute or early infection. Results of these tests depend on several factors, including the time from onset of illness, concentration of virus in the specimen, the quality of specimen collected from a person, and how is it processed, and the precise formulation of reagents in the test kits. The sensitivity of these tests might be expected to vary from 34% to 80%. So that means sensitivity is not that good. Based on this information, half or more of COVID-19 infected patients might be missed by such tests, depending on the group of patient tested. These assumptions urgently require further study to understand whether they are accurate or not. Additionally, false positive results, that is, a test showing that a person is infected when they are not, could occur if the antibodies on the test strips also recognize antigen of viruses other than COVID-19, such as from human coronavirus that cause common cold. These tests could potentially be used as a triage test to rapidly identify patients who are very likely to have COVID-19, reducing or eliminating the need for expensive molecular confirmatory testing. With the limited data now available, WHO, that is World Health Organization, does not recommend the use of antigen detecting rapid diagnostic test for patient care. Although research into their performance and potential diagnostic utility is highly encouraged. Second, rapid diagnostic test based on post-antibody detection. This test detects the presence of antibodies in the blood of people believed to have been infected with COVID-19. Antibodies are produced over days to weeks after infection with the virus. The strength of antibody response is also dependent on several factors, including age, nutritional status, severity of disease, certain medication, or infection like HIV that suppress the immune response. Studies suggest that a majority of patients develop antibody response only in the second week after onset of symptoms. I have given references of all these studies in the description of this video. This means that a diagnosis of COVID-19 infection based on antibody response will only be possible in the recovery phase, when many of the opportunities for clinical intervention or interruption of disease transmission have already passed. Antibody detection tests targeting COVID-19 may also cross-react with other pathogens, including other human coronaviruses, and give false positive results. Lastly, there have been discussions about whether rapid diagnostic tests detecting antibodies could predict whether an individual was immune to the infection with COVID-19 virus or not. There is no evidence till date to support this. Tests to detect antibody response to COVID-19 in the population will be critical to support the development of vaccines and to add to our understanding of the extent of infection among people who are not identified through active case finding or surveillance efforts. For clinical diagnosis, however, such tests have limited utility because they cannot quickly diagnose acute infection to inform actions needed to determine the course of treatment. Based on current data, WHO does not recommend the use of antibody detecting rapid diagnostic tests for patient care, but encourages the continuation of work to establish their usefulness in disease surveillance and epidemiological research. Third, RTPCR, that is reverse transcriptase polymerase chain reaction. This is the gold standard test. In this test, a sample is collected from parts of body where the coronavirus gathers, such as person's nose or throat. The sample is treated with several chemical solutions that remove substances such as proteins and fats and extracts only the RNA present in the sample. This extracted RNA is a mix of person's own genetic material and, if present, coronavirus's RNA. The RNA is a reverse transcribe to DNA using a specific enzyme. Scientists then add additional short fragments of DNA that are complementary to specific parts of transcribed viral DNA. These fragments attach themselves to target section of the viral DNA if the virus is present in the sample. Some of the added genetic fragments are for building DNA strands during amplification, while the others are for building the DNA and adding markers labeled to the strands, which are then used to detect virus. The mixture is then placed in an RT-PCR machine. The machine cycles to temperatures that heat and cool the mixtures to trigger specific chemical reactions that create new identical copies of target sections of viral DNA. The cycle repeats over and over to continue copying the target sections of viral DNA. Each cycle doubles the previous amount. Two copies become four, four copies becomes eight, and so on. A standard real-time RT-PCR setup usually goes through 35 cycles, which means that by the end of process, around 35 billion new copies of the section of viral DNA are created from each strand of the virus present in the sample. Scientists also monitor how many cycles it takes to reach this level in order to estimate the severity of the infection. Fewer the cycles, more severe the viral infection is. The real-time RT-PCR technique is highly sensitive and specific, more than 90%, and takes an average between 6 to 8 hours. Compared to other available virus isolation methods, real-time RT-PCR has a lower potential for contamination or errors, as the entire process can be done within a closed tube. it continues to be the most accurate method available for the detection of coronavirus or COVID-19. To detect past infection, which is important for understanding the development and spread of virus, real-time RT-PCR cannot be used as the viruses are only present in the body for a specific window of time. So in the present time, RT-PCR is considered as an ideal gold standard test for COVID-19. So this was all about diagnostic tests available for COVID-19. I'll come up with new video if any update in the treatment or management comes. Till then, take very good care of yourself and your loved ones. Take appropriate precautions like wearing mask, good hand washing, maintain distance, and refrain yourself from going to the crowded places. Thank you guys for watching this video. Stay healthy and safe.